Me lo abrazaste and I'm going to talk to you about superheroes cyber power, how to make a student with school difficulties. First, I'm going to tell you an introduction of the teaching of the project, the didactical methodology for cooperative learning, the activities and timing, the evaluation of the students, the results and discussion, the physical and associates, the project evaluation, the trial results, the environmental proposal, and some conclusions. Last year, I studied a master for training teachers on secondary education. With that master, I have to do some practice in the last year of a high school. The students from my class was learned the two previous years into the program for the improvement of learning and performance. So this student should use motivation and a little interest for learning science. That's the reason why I decided to use a topic that was attractive and interesting to learn how to do a research project. So I propose to investigate the science behind the power of superheroes. The principal objective of this project is the motivation of the students. Another important objective is to teach the students how to do a research project. For that, I use an active methodology. So students can learn how to do a research project by doing it. The information and communication technologies are a very important part of this project. And to promote the autonomy of these students and their skills, we work throughout individual work in some cases or cooperative work in others. The project consists in a paper who exposed the scientific principles and displaying the powers of different superheroes. Several posters with some different superheroes with the superpowers and the scientific principles that explain it. A graphic that shows the comparison between scientific reality and the fiction that we find in movies and comics. And a cover made by the students with different superheroes involved in the project. I use cooperative learning during all the project. For that, I made formal cooperative groups. In that groups, students work each other and they complete a specific task. The organization of the groups are different for different tasks. They work individually for search information, assumption information, and oral presentation. They work in groups of two or three students for new posters, the comparative graphs, and the sign of cover. Another studio is going together into the rest of the planning and the hypothesis and other the paper. I assign roles to the students. And I make heterogeneous groups in such a way they can help each other. The activities and timing for this project are the next. During the research project learning, students have to decide how to do this project. They have to find the study hypothesis and they choose can science explain the superpowers and can science recreate the superpowers in real life. Each student chooses a superhero and they have to search information about it, their superpowers and the scientific principles who rules them. They have to resume this information and use it to write a paper that contains this information and other sections like data, conclusions. They have to do a comparative graph with the different superheroes and the level of scientific reality who is shown in their movies and comics. They have to do several posters with different superheroes and the scientific principles who rules their superpowers. And they have to design a cover. All of these activities was made during a month in several sessions, as you can see in the table. The evaluation of the students was made in different ways. I evaluate by classroom observation the level of implication of the students in the project. I evaluate the final result of the paper and the information provided by each student to it. I evaluate the posters, graph, and cover, attending to the originality of the designs and the information provided by each student. I evaluate the oral presentation for some expositions made by the students with the scientific principles who rules the power of the superheroes. The qualification criteria that was used was shown in the table. I consider more important cooperative work than individual. The level of acquisition of the objectives of the students was great. The grades obtained by the students at the end of the project was positive, as you can see in this graphic. The students learned how to do a research project and the scientific principles of the power of a superhero. The project increased the motivation of the students and the autonomy, and favored the learning of the disease. For evaluation of the project, I wrote to the student a test in which students saw a great grade of agreement of the next sentences. Project makes sessions more dynamic and active. Project motivates interest in science. Project makes students more implicated in classroom, and project is interesting because it's about attractive topics. The final result of the paper was a paper who has 12 pages, including abstracts, justification, paperwork, materials and methods, introduction, results and discussion, conclusions and reference. Three posters, as you can see, a graph that compares the number of powers of each superhero that can be explained by science, which is not, but not complete, and a cover of the paper. For improvement in the project, we can learn the transversal elements in education through the use of comics like this. We can enrich the project through collaboration with other departments of the institute, like language department, if we write the paper in English. I wish to compare the results obtained in this project using a control group, but in my high school, there is a group of students with similar characteristics that I have, so I couldn't. In conclusion, the theme of superheroes is very attractive for the students. When students are motivated, their learning is better and are more implicated on it. The use of attractive methodology is motivating and encourages learning. Cooperative works allow students to help each other to understand the content and to do the activities. The students' learning were more effective and they were more motivated. We have a new power of superheroes, motivated students with difficulties.